Well, Galileo Resources is to hunt for near-surface copper at the Homeep target at its Concordia project in South Africa starting next month. Well, joining me now is Chairman and Chief Executive Colin Bird. So, Colin, modelling's there suggesting high grades at the prospect. What kind of grades are we talking?
That's right, and of course, high grade is the moving target. Generally, in today's near-surface mines, open-pit mines, they're massive, and they literally go down to 0.35. There's a mine in Canada being developed at 3.7. So when you start talking 0.8 and north and open-pittable, that is relatively high-grade. In fact, that is high-grade for an open pit. But we did publish in our annual report, and we did publish in a press release, a table which showed about 700 million tons at around about 0.58 that we're talking about. So in actual fact, everything being relative, anything in the 0.8 is quite a margin above 0.58. So yes, the Homeep, of course, is only one of our targets, and the Homeep is a trend. It's quite a big trend, some 6 kilometres long, and that was a tiny part of it. But we were saying to our investors and shareholders, look, this is the sort of results we're pulling, and of course, at sporadic places along that would-be strike is that sort of material quite close to surface.
Okay, now in your statement you also talk about IP, or I think it's induced polarisation as a tool having universal success. For those not familiar with the acronym or the tool, with what degree of accuracy are we talking?
I don't think accuracy is the word, but as we go on in life, it gets more and more telling. I think how telling is it, or how indicative is it of sulfides? And it is very indicative down to about 250 metres, although some of the major companies and some of the advanced geophysics companies can go down to 1,000 metres in this day and age, but we're not going there. So really what you're doing, you're putting the charge in the ground, and without going into too much of the science, some rocks hold charge, others don't. In a particular area, there's a signature for how much charge they hold. And so the danger always is that saltwater solution, graphite, magnetite, iron can actually confuse you. In this particular case, the rock types, the lithology, and the copper signature is fairly well understood in IP. So quick answer would be, provided there's a good dissemination, the IP will in actual fact point us prior to drilling to where the best spots are, and the guys who handle the raw data will in actual fact be able to sift out what is lower grade, 0.4 say, and what is higher grade, 1% say. So it is a very, very good tool. And of course, we benefit from the structure. There have been, from the history. There has been mines in the area, lots of mines in the area. So we're going to run some geophysics over known copper, which means that when we go to the unknown, we'll be able to discern whether or not the area is copper bearing, and the level of dissemination. Okay. So yes, it will be a very good tool for us.
Okay, so let's stick with what we know. So what will be the next steps where the Concordia is concerned?
Well, I've got this massive data bank of drill holes, and almost at the point where we could produce a resource from previous work. But of course, independents aren't going to sign off unless I do some twinning. So the next thing is to twin some holes where the IP shows all of the right noises, and then where we've got extension to those holes to do some more reconnaissance to grow the size of the deposits. And so it's partly confirmatory and partly reconnaissance, but drilling that we'll be doing is the next exercise after IP.
Okay, and timelines, will that be in the next 6 months, 12 months?
Timelines, well, before this call I was reading the quotes for the IP. We expect to award that contract, and we expect to start before the end of the month. I expect that to be a 2 month exercise. And, it's not the death of a thousand lashes. We should be building up data, building up interest as we go along. So I wouldn't be surprised if we're not drilling in January next year. Of course, you know, once you get to December in South Africa, you have there's that month off that they used to call the contractor's holiday, but now, I guess, goes throughout the country, and December is a very flat month for doing anything in South Africa.
Okay, so you're not taking any holiday then. So what are you devoting your energies to?
Holidays haven't been in my agenda for a long time now. I'm afraid it's everything on the run, and, you know, I've been getting nice projects like Concordia is almost an holiday in its own right.
Oh, I'm glad to hear that. Otherwise, I'll start to worry about you, Colin. So what are you what are you devoting your energies to in the coming 12 months? Is it South Africa primarily, or your gold project in Nevada?
Oh, well, the gold project, but Nevada is bound to be secondary to Concordia. Concordia, I think, has got all the markings, all the makings of a big project. So I'm going to get in there and do exactly like we did with Kiwara. I don't know if you can recall that one, where we sold off to First Quantum for $285 million. It was all about the trade. The trade have to know, investors have to know, the trade have to know what a good project we're on. And we'll be embarking next year and the end of this year on making sure the trade knows exactly what we've got at Concordia, what the likely envelope size is going to be of this project. And we did announce the other day we've got a three-year exploration license, so that's good. We can do everything properly, but we're not waiting 3 years. I'm hoping by the middle of next year I've got an envelope and really know what Concordia is all about.
Lovely. Colin Bird.
And the Nevada properties, there's quite a lot of corporate action around them. As you know, we sold Gabs, and there's still quite a bit of interest in all our other properties, although you don't sell a motor car if you don't know what it's worth. So I think we'll spend a bit of time on our Ferber project, which seems to be attracting a lot of interest.
Thank you. Colin Bird, Chief Executive and Chairman of Galileo Resources, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.